until my friend is Australian makes a dingo with the terms.
He's satisfied with the payment, appreciates the correct currency, and the delivery will be made within the next 24 hours.
Morning, Charlie.
Morning, Mr. Payette.
How's the family?
Fine. Wife and I want to thank you for what you did for my son.
Oh, you thank a member of Parliament. I talked to him, he pulled all the strings. He's a hard worker.
A lot of people would be a lot happy if next time you'd stand for local member.
Well, the cure is all. I'll finish him first.
Come on, Jack.
What I wanted to talk to you about was, I'd like to move on.
That's the best man in the country, of course.
Of course he knew that, didn't he?
Well, I wouldn't have imported you from Kentucky.
Is it valuable to lose?
What is it, more money?
No, it's not the money.
Well, maybe we're too isolated for
you. Tell you what you do, Harry. Take a week off, go to Sydney, live it up. I'll pick up the joint.
No, I don't want that either. What the hell do you want?
You told me that your work was always quiet stuff. You never got any heat from the police. Well, this time, this guy's going to be a national hero. You're going to have every cop in the world looking for you.
miles and an ocean away, Harry. What makes you think it was me?
Your routine. First, the quiet phone calls from overseas. And you do your phony accents. And then you travel. You don't take much to figure out. You're gone about a week. That's long enough to get a look at the guy, watch his routines, his movements. And last week, you come back with your equipment. The golf bag this time, meaning you're going through airport security. I mean, you've been through this routine 3 times this year.
Tell me the truth, Harry. Deep, deep down in that blatantly cynical heart of yours, not the truth you're afraid of, isn't it that this time a supposed good guy got killed?
Not any good guys or bad guys in my world. Just me. And what happens on the outside in your world, I don't even want to know about. I just want to be left to myself.
And it really is the local police you worry about.
Well, like my daddy used to say, if you don't go troubling trouble, trouble won't trouble you. I just want to get out of here.
Let me tell you something, Harry. You didn't just get lucky when you left me in the day. You were carefully selected. Not to know you were. You've got a file of your mile long. You were dark meat, hanging on a hook when I pulled you out of the rain.
I know what I owe you. I just want a chance
don't
to get...
Don't trust me, Harry? Yes, sure. Well, believe me when I tell you there's nothing to worry about. The police interested you're so concerned about will disappear in a couple of days. The newspapers will be carrying something else by then. But they'll have discovered that this honest crusader who is gunned down wasn't so honest after all. He didn't take care of it. An informant to boot. The killing was just an inter-family squabble. And the newspapers in Sydney couldn't give a stuff about the U.S. crime war. Worry about. Anything else you want to talk about?
I guess not.
Harry.
Don't ever come to me again and say you want to move on. I've told you before, in 2 years I'll be retired. You'll be free. The Australian status will be fully established. If you try to make a move on your own, I'll explode your feelings like a melon. Understand?
Loud and clear.
Harry, get the bags out of the van. There's a good chap.
I'll be leaving now.
Yes. Thank you for coming.
Here's my bill.
Claude, who got it?
Well, to me. Hand me the bill.
Come here, me, Claude.
Father, will you stay with the boy for a moment, please?
Shall we pray?
I'm afraid he only speaks French, Father.
Come, my son. Get it.
Get to the...
There is a deal to me, Doctor. Hold it. The government will get up to me. Now we must get those sheep up before they're away.
Oh, for God's sake, that can wait.
No, it can't. And neither can finding the boy's uncle. That's the next thing we have to do.
Uh-huh.
You come and help me get the sheep out from under us.
Batman, it's up to you. What are you going to do?
Just a minute. I'm down $15 tonight.
I don't know where.
Maybe on the road somewhere coming down here.
Can I help you with your bag?
I'm looking for Mr. Jean Payet.
Oh, Mr. Payet.
Didn't you know him?
Everyone around these parts knows Mr. Payet.
If you could tell me where I can find him.
Well, he's probably in farm. Just a couple of miles out.
Is there someone who can take us there? A taxi or something?
Harry's in front.
You better go get him, Rob. What's your name, then?
He doesn't understand English. He's just there. It's not mine. It comes from New Caledonia.
Well, would you like to come and sit inside?
Go put it your foot, brother.
Harry, this lady says she has some business with Mr. Payet.
What sort of business?
Customer.
Well, hell, you don't need me.
Look at me, Luke. I want you to take me to Monsieur Payet.
Listen, lady, I'm down 13 bucks in a poker game in there. And I'll save you a lot of time. Mr. Payet is dead set against strangers.
I asked him to be here to deliver this boy to his uncle.
That's my ute over there. You and the boy get in and I'll be back in a minute.
Well, you know, I really cannot thank you.
Just doing my Christian duty.
Really?
Thank you. No.
Because my sister was always afraid of me.
Yes, yes.
Did you know her long?
No, not that long. She and the boy came to us from Sydney a few weeks ago. Ah, we never realized she was a victim. We didn't even know she had any relatives till after she died, and we went to her papers.
Did you contact anybody, the authorities or anybody, before you brought the boy out here?
Well, I didn't know who to talk to. I suppose when I go back, then...
No. I'll handle all the details from now on. And we'll make a good home for it.
I'll show you. You're sure he will have a wonderful life with you. Well, I suppose there's nothing else to be said. If your man will take me back to town, I can catch the bus, which is supposed to arrive around midnight.
No, but I won't have you taking that ride again. Now, you're going to stay the night, and after a good rest and a nice breakfast in the morning, I'll drive you back.
Oh, that's very nice. I don't think so. May I find a bit of a
phone in?
You have a phone?
Of course I have a phone. Oh, you tried to call here, did you?
Yes, but the operator couldn't even give me a number.
Yes, I'm sorry. I like my privacy and the phone numbers under here. Will you call me?
I don't know.
I have to go back myself anyway, because it's a few weeks later, but it doesn't do. And of course, I really must be in there for you. Well, thank you, and your time.
Well, I suppose
not. Hey, Ed, can I talk to you for a minute?
Now, you use the phone, and then I'll show you the guest room. Just dial 02, and then your number.
Yes, sir.
Well, what do you want, Harry?
He can't be serious about keeping it. What the hell are you going to do with a kid around here?
It's nothing as sinister as you seem to have in mind, Harry. I'm driving the little old lady home. Because we don't want her yakking the people back on the bus now, do we? Relax, Harry. He doesn't speak English, remember?
Gente, mon
boss.
Gente.
Mon petit. Mon petit boss.
When I get home, I'll phone my solicitor and have him find a boarding school somewhere.
Okay?
Hello, baby.
Beautiful.
They're Arabians, my dear. The oldest and purest breed developed by man. Would you like to go?
Mm-hmm.
Paul. Embrasse, Madame Jabir. Mon petit.
Au revoir, Paul.
Kid. I don't like her either.
left a French-English dictionary on the counter in the kitchen. Might help us try this.
How long is that going to be?
Day after tomorrow.
Smile. You shouldn't let it bother you that he ran away. It was good watching him while we could, wasn't it? That's what you gotta learn about life, kid. Good parts only come in bits and pieces. Not very often. Oh, your teeth. Say teeth.
Teeth.
Very nice. Very good. Wouldn't it be a hell of a lot easier if one of us spoke the other one's language? Well, come on. We're going to play. We ain't done all night. Well, there aren't any more, so I just have to be light 15, all right? Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. I just got... Hey, you could have a hard bargain. I wasn't looking. Sure, I got some more. I'm in the money. There and show me what you got. Now you can keep it. You want it fair and square. All right. Got them thick. Do you lose? You kind of bend and win. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here they come. Five of them, down and dirty. Okay, hold on. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I can retire on this hand. Hello?
talk to who? I want to speak to the Aussie called Dingo.
I don't know anything. I'm going to pull this slop and get himself killed.
All right, sport. Stop it. We're not going to know each other that long, so just... Lord. Well, it doesn't make any difference. Don't you think I know how you feel? You can't let it make any difference.
If you want to survive, you can't get close to anybody.
Mm-hmm. was you, Paul? He seems to have perked up a bit, doesn't he?
Yeah, he found a dead too.
Nothing on it.
What the good people of this town watching are supposed to be.
There's nothing inside you, is there?
Hello. Comment ça marche, hein?
Hein?
Paris? Tu l'aimes bien?
Oh, non, non.
Well, he seems to have taken quite a fancy to you.
Well, he didn't have much choice, did he? I was the only one around. By the way, you got a phone call night before last. I think it might have been one of your business calls.
What makes you think that?
Well, he asked for an Australian named Dingo. Does that mean anything to you?
What did you say to him?
I don't know what to say to him. Next time, I knew you hung up.
See you back at the house.
Hey, before you go on another one of your trips, you will find a school for the boy, won't you?
Well, it's all possible. There's no point in him hanging around here any longer than necessary, is there?
You know what a dingo is, kid? The wild dog known to be vicious, mean, sneaky. Well, he sure named himself right, didn't he? You may not know it, but the sooner you're away from them, the better off you'll be. Yeah.
Yeah. It's too bad things didn't work out different.
Now, we could have made a great team. We could have cleaned up all the poker games in the bush and made it on to the big time. Well, I could have been your manager. Come on, get in the front.
Dog's two jingles up pretty good before we shot him. Drop the gun.
Where's the black guy?
Oh, you mean Harry? He's in town.
When'll he be back?
What? Should be soon.
All right. We're gonna go inside now. But one funny move from you, and you're very dead.
Fellas here to rob me, are you?
Shut up and stay right where you are. We're here to sell you something. Jingles? Spare the man the merchandise. Open it up. Jingles, keep an eye out for the black guy. Let's put it this way, mate. I've got a friend, a Yank, who's a very good friend of the man who hired you for your last job. We decided to go into business for ourselves. In fact, I came back on the same plane as you, except I was traveling tourist class. The price was $300,000.
Must be out of your mind. I don't have that kind of money.
You're the best there is. So good, you're hired all over the world at $300,000 a time, and nobody even knows what you look like, except me. No photographs. Now, I'd say that's worth what you got for your last job. And I'm prepared to bet your life if you've got the money. If you like what I did to your dogs, next, I'm going to start on your Arrow Force.
My money's invested out of the country. They're quite a wild game.
I told you it wasn't going to work, didn't I? I told you it
was. I have records. I can show you what's going to do.
Kill him. Let's get out of here while we can.
How long would it take?
Dave?
I told you it wasn't going to work, didn't I?
How do we know you're not going to double cross us? that's not enough to convince you. You're only told by a good partner.
You're not a bad sort of a kid. I mean, for a kid.
Come on, help.
Wait a minute, what's happening here?
Ain't gonna bother me to kill you, nigga. Get in the house.
We can leave the kid out of this, can't we?
Both of you, move!
Idea. You had to kill the dog, didn't you? And then you
cut him up, didn't you? You should have handled him better. You know that?
Well, I didn't. What's it all about? Well, it doesn't matter anymore, does it? What do the kids have to see?
Listen. Listen. Ces deux-là, c'est des trois méchants. Tu comprends? Mais tu n'as plus besoin d'avocat. Parce que la police sera très contente. Why did he have to kill the dog?
Listen, we'll make a little grave for them in front of the house. Bury their toys with them. You get the front end loader and the back end. Find a place way back in the orchard. Dig a hole big enough for these animals.
The boy's father shot. Why don't I put him to bed first?
I said these other three.
You're not going to off the kid, are you?
You see me kill a guy.
He's just a kid.
The matter's not open for discussion.
Run! Get out of here!
Now, Harry, I've got to say, stop now with that never happened. Harry, you're a lousy kid. Nobody cares if he dies. Kids die every day. Get out of here! That's your little
friend.
Thank you. after this lousy 200.
He's got a whole bundle of them.
Maybe 15 minutes before he gets that used together. Here. What the hell are you doing? About 15 minutes before he realizes we're not on the road ahead of him. If we're lucky, that's 15 minutes out, 15 minutes back. I guess it's about a half an hour. The only problem is there's not much the other way either. I don't know if he can turn you over to. I mean, around here, your uncle, people think he walks on water. Well, come on.
You haven't seen Harry, have you, in the rover, go past in the last few minutes?
No, sir, Mr. Payette. Not in the last 20 minutes.
Uh-huh. Nothing important.
I've got
never track us in the bush. Come on. relaxing. You're safe now. We may as well get some rest. We've got a long trip ahead of us. I have no foggiest notion where we're going. Come on, get some. Come on. Only problem is we've got to find someplace safe for you, you know. And even in a big city, I can't go to the cops. I mean, I have a devil of a time trying to convince them what your uncle is. And even if they did believe me, you don't know how I knew. How come I didn't do anything for so long? Don't you worry.
Yeah, this is the dingo. You sure this line's clear? All right. Where I need help is in catching a man who's working for me. So I know he's on a freight train, heading west, shipping into the moving after. Now listen. I've done a lot of favors for the organization. Now I want some. If I don't get it, there'll be a lot more of my friends will have to. It shouldn't be hard to spot him. He's a black man. 6'3", 200 pounds, traveling with a small boy. He's about 10 years old. Now, when you do spot it, I want a helicopter and a pilot. The pilot must be talented.
You know, I didn't get into reading until I was 24 years old. And I'd been in prison for 7 years by then. And after 12 years in prison, one night, six of us just went over the wall. One of the guards chasing us. He drowned in the swamps. And I'm wanted for murder, too. See, that's what your uncle had on me. That's why I had to keep on working for him. Even though I knew what he was doing. I'm an escaped convict. As far as he's concerned, I'm the perfect employee. You want to know what I was in prison for? Well, it is a case. The sheriff had us set up. He was running for re-election against a black lawyer. As it was beginning to look like the black lawyer was going to win, three black boys got arrested for raping a white man. My brother, Jamie, and his friend, they got the electric chair. And since I was just 17, they decided to be lenient with me. They just gave me 99 years. Guess what? The sheriff got reelected. You must think I'm crazy sitting here talking to myself. That's not the point of it. I wasn't saying anything important. Not that it means anything to anybody. It's all right. You're safe, fellas. Soup. Soup. Not that I don't appreciate the offer. I'm sorry, Paul.
To keep up. I can stop that. You know, not having me for a pop is not the worst thing in the world that can happen to you, you know. Come on. I'm going to tell you the truth. I mean, there's a lot in me who would like to be your papa, but that's not the way I live my life, you know. I'm not ready for that kind of... Look at you. I mean, you stir up all this trouble and then you broke off like a damn frog and pop and... Just because you don't get your own way. I mean, man, I don't need you in my life right now. I mean, I was doing great with my life until you came along. Oh. I was doing terrific. Well, at least I didn't have your maniac uncle chasing me down trying to kill me, you know? Come on, kid. Will you give me a break? I mean, I haven't done anything except for a few bucks or whatever I've needed in here. I don't know where I'm going, except as far away from your uncle as I can get it. Must have stashed the rest of it. Banked it somewhere. $6,000 ain't exactly the jackpot, you know, but it's better than a poke in the eye with a sharp stick, ain't it? Trace us here real easy, so we gotta keep moving. Gotta find a highway. I found them running across the town.
Come on.
wouldn't have got very far in this one anyway. I had to yank all the wires out. The light wouldn't go on when we got out of the car. Come on. Be looking for this about now. Well, you can't exactly say this is like stealing, can you? I mean, show me a man with $6,000, and I'll show you an upstanding citizen. Come on.
I bet you're hungry, huh? Hungry?
Yeah, me too.
You're choking on a couple scotches. Oh, yeah. Terrific. You know that Australia is the only country in the world where the kookaburras live? Most people think they come from Africa. That somebody once got their last funny, so they put it in a Tarzan movie. Now they put it in all the jungle movies.
Tarzan?
You know Tarzan?
Oh.
You're a rat, you know that?
What?
Yeah, a dirty little rat. I've been thinking about what you asked me and how I responded. You know, I didn't even get to the books until I was about 20 years old or so. It's all because of this funny little Jewish man. I say he was funny because his driving ambition in life was to establish this whole chain of Hebrew schools. And this is right in the heart of Hillbillyland. Hashim Shelley Harry. But don't tell me. Vi'ani Akavir Shahak. That I want to be your friend. In Hebrew. I guess what it all boils down to is, I know it doesn't make any sense. I mean, the whole idea is crazy. What the hell, the whole world is crazy. Just read the newspapers. I guess what I'm trying to say is that, well, if Paul still wants Harry to be his papa, I'm willing to give it a chance.
Paul's papa?
Oui. Paul's papa. Hey! He's got to realize we don't mean to cause him any trouble. And he'll leave us alone. Then we'll be free and we'll have a chance. I think I've got a name for it. How about Lucky?
Lucky?
Yeah, that's what they call this country. And believe me, that's what we're going to need a lot of.
$600. Apart from the burning of the little oil, it runs like a charm.
Can I drive her?
Sure, sure. Don't believe me. Have a go. Be my guest. In the visor.
Where else? This is Allen. Tell Payette I've spotted him. He's just left here driving a white Leyland. He's heading southwest towards the Blue Mountains, and I'm right behind him.
Black guy has killed me.
Is that right?
Always bitching and moaning about being a minority. Try being a midget sometime.
I guess you got a point.
Damn right I do. Ever heard of a midget being heavyweight champion of the world?
No, I can't say I have.
Well, don't get me wrong. I'm not bigoted. But we've got black midgets as well, you know. Hey, what's wrong?
Nothing. I decided to buy.
Good. We'll go back to the station and we'll fill out the paper.
I'll throw in an extra $200 if we forget about the paper. I mean, we don't need them, right? I tell you what. I'll even leave the car parked along the way. Just give us 3 days. You can report it stolen. And you'll have your $800 and your car back, too.
What kind of trouble are you in?
We sort of had to borrow a car in the last town we were in. But there's a man after us. I mean, he wants to kill us. Both of us. Other than the car, we haven't broken any laws. $400? Hey, man, we need your help.
You're not lying to me?
No. Just give us 3 days, no more. And I'll leave the car, just like I said.
I didn't think that.
No, I'm not lying about anything.
Got a boy me own, 7 years of age, and he's already bigger than I am.
Well, you're welcome to the money.
We know it, we've got to stick together, don't we? Good luck.
Well, we're off. Now, with any luck, we'll be well away by tonight. Then maybe, who knows, maybe a plane to someplace where we can get lost. You know, there's lots of islands in the Pacific. You know, when I was a kid, I saw this movie with Humphrey Bogart in the Florida Keys somewhere. Yeah, a man and a boy can get lost in the island. Well, here's looking at you, kid. Last pit stop. Better get something while we can. You know, one of you is starting to smell pretty raunchy. All right, it must be you. Change over there. Good day, mate.
Good day.
What do you got good to take away?
Something hot. Yeah, I'll be all right.
Hey, when they all organize.
Okay. Hey,
Watch it.
You need a C&I dog, too, don't you? All right.
Thank you. That sucker won't give up. Coming back again and again. I mean, no matter how far we run, he'll be right behind us. Once you jump over a cliff, there's no turning back, is it? You know, one way or another, I've been running all my life. I'm getting sick of it. That's the last thing your uncle would expect, for me to stop running, just pick our own spot and take him on. Well, dogs do that, you know. It's a good thing I kept your old shirt. Yeah. Go ahead, Ken. Now, as long as we stand in the cover of those trees, I think we'll be okay. Keep the highway in sight long enough. Sooner or later, we're bound to come across something.
That's a resort hotel. You might not stick out like sore thumbs. This may be the chance for a whole new beginning for us. I don't think he'll try anything here, at least not until your uncle arrives. I need to ask for a favor, for you to trust me and to take care of Paul for a few days. I can't say there won't be a certain amount of danger. If you decide to help, if I haven't come for him in 3 days, take him and the enclosed envelope to the police in the city. It's important that it be a large police department. The man who wants to kill us is the boy's uncle. He's very bright and can be very charming. He would probably either con or intimidate the boy out of the custody of a less sophisticated department. Without you, we're lost. Now, all we have to do is figure out a way to put our friend out of commission for a while.
Sure,
I'm sorry. I'll just sit around.
Thank you.
Some kind of pervert. Says he's naked.
Naked? God!
God, I wish you could understand. This has got to be. God's not very good for either one of us, you know. And if we're ever going to have a chance, I have to try. So you're just going to have to wait for me. Attendez-moi. Attendez-moi. Wait. I'm going to try my damnedest.
I'll be with me, just...
Sure, and I'm well.
I'll get the boy in.
Yes, you.
Thank you.
Evening. I'm here to pick up my foreman and my nephew, a small boy and a good-looking American, black. What room are they in again?
American room?
Oh, yes, sir. They said they'd meet you in the lounge. They left you a note. In the lounge? Oh, thank you. Where is that?
The director's room, sir. Bar
closes at 1:30. Safety in numbers, I have.
You got it.
Scotch. Where is our little waif, our little nephew?
Upstairs. He went open the door as he hears my voice. Saying something we prearranged.
How quick. Thank you. See, you had yourself a little fun with Alan. Had him arrested as a pervert. I love him, Alan.
He did give you my message.
Yes, he did. He said you wanted to trade for the boy. Trade for what?
My life. I now know I can't get away from you, not if you really want to catch me. I just want to go home my own way. I mean, I can't be tied down to that kid forever.
Harry, you don't want to come back to the farm. Take up where we left off.
I think I'll pass on that offer of Christian charity. Look, I'm not the one who's a danger to you. Only the boy can be that. What the hell can I do? I gotta stay away from the cops just as much as you do. Once the boy is out of the way, you've got nothing to worry about.
All right, Harry. You got a deal. There's no waste any time. We'll go upstairs. You can do your number at the door, and I'll take the little fella off your hands.
No.
What do you mean, no?
I'd just soon be far away from here when you come to collect the boy. I mean, I'd feel a lot more comfortable if I knew you were at a safe distance when I take off.
I said I agreed to your deal.
Let's just say I'm being overly cautious. Now look, you do it my way or it's going to be very messy. I have your friend's gun and I'll use it if I have to.
What do you have in mind?
About a half mile from here. There's a lookout ledge overlooking the Megalong Valley. You leave your car at the top. It's about 100 steps down to the bottom. And from where I'll be watching, I'll be able to see when you're alone.
Normally cautious, you're scared, Steve, aren't you?
Sunrise tomorrow at 5:49. You be on that ledge then. You stay there until 6 o'clock. When you go back up the steps, the boy will be there.
and I'll be long gone.
5:49.
Somebody once told me that if you don't believe in something strong enough to die for, you're not really alive. I never knew he's talking about until now.
And you know something? In a funny sort of way, it feels good.
Harry, with or without the gun, I can take you 12 different ways.
I only need one. The difference is I'm going to take you with me. I just want you dead.
Go with me. Harry, you're talking crazy.
Blue Harry.
You didn't shoot me. You can't do it, can you? You can't kill me in cold blood, can you?
You know why?
Because it takes a very special kind of man, Harry.
Like you?
Like me. Very special, since I was a child. I'll pay you all that money. Give me the gun. I'll make you a rich man.
Tonight at 8:30 on 9, Richard Tyson from Two Moon Junction stars in a brand new series, Hardball. It's action with a difference as a hard-hitting bike-riding cop is forced to team up with the toughest old-timer on the force. They're a team nothing can beat if they stay together. Hardball, starting tonight, 8:30 on 9.